Hello, Truman. I'm Allie Smart.
And I'm Taylor Hickman, and here's your February edition of Patriot Vision.
National Honor Society recently inducted new students. Reporter Taylor Hickman has more on this story.
National Honor Society had their induction on January 28th. 44 students who have participated in leadership roles has maintained a grade point average of 3.0, has done service hours and volunteer work, and is all around a great student who were inducted. Congratulations to the following. The NHS induction was a huge success. I'm Taylor Hickman, reporting for THS Patriot Vision.
Stephanie's Bridal Boutique recently had a fashion show. Truman students helped showcase prom dresses. Ty Feldkamp has the inside look.
Illusion through the front with a cool tool on the outside. Heating goes all the way down.
The fashion show was held at Stephanie's Bridal Boutique on February 22nd. Truman students were able to participate by wearing dresses from the boutique and escorting the girls. Mackenzie Wilson, Jr. expresses that for her, the fashion show was really fun and a great experience. Her favorite dress was a red lace long dress, and they bought it so she could wear it to prom next year. Isabel Reese, Jr. expressed that her favorite dress was a polka dot dress because it was retro, and that she would definitely do a fashion show again because it was very fun. Becky Tebe, Jr. expressed that it was really fun to see her friends and other people wear dresses that she's never seen before. Her favorite dress was the black dress that Chloe Miller wore. The fashion show was a huge success. I'm Ty Feldkamp, reporting for THS Patriot Vision.
Truman Wrestling had a great season, and Nathan Kroner shows how they prepared for the season.
Truman Boys Varsity Wrestling had a great season this year by sending one wrestler to state and also beating tough opponents at home and on the road. Junior Kane Kaiser tells us how he prepared for this upcoming wrestling season.
To train for wrestling, I've been doing a lot of conditioning and working on all my moves to make them better. My season's been pretty good. I've won some tough matches, but I've lost some that I shouldn't have, but I'm going to work harder to win at districts.
Senior Kurt Kaiser tells us how he prepared for this upcoming wrestling season in a state run.
What I did to train was I just went to the gym and decided that I wanted to at least do 5 miles or so each day just so I can get my stamina up and everything just in case I needed it for in a long match or a district tournament that will seat me well at districts.
Best moment of the season was when I made it to state was being able to say that I was good enough to make it to state and best of Missouri and everything. And it was a great experience. I want to shout out my coaches and everything for pushing me and being able to go to state and everything. And then good luck to Jonathan and Kane next year.
I'm Nathan Kroner, signing out for THS Patriot Vision. Go Patriots!
The swim team had a great season. Reporter TJ Scott and Richard Manessis has the inside look.
On Wednesday, January 26, 2015, the girls' swimming team had their annual senior night. Not only were the girls recognized for their commitment to swimming until their senior year, but they were also recognized for their display of talents in the pool. Junior diver Sarah Mancini had some kind words to say about her senior teammates.
The seniors have been really supportive in everything I do, and everybody else on the team, they're just really supportive.
Many of the girls compete in events in the pool, such as team relays and singles races, while others prefer to display their talents outside of the pool by diving.
I like diving more than swimming because I don't like having to swim for long periods of time because I don't have the stamina to do it, but diving really gives me the thrill, doing flips and like being high in the air.
This is TJ Scott reporting for THS Patriot Vision.
Here's your entertainment segment, Patriot Talk.
Hey guys, welcome to our first episode of Patriot Talk. Bobby Shmurda went to jail for drug and weapon charges about a month ago. And
yeah, it's kind of weird.
Yeah, he's going to be there for a pretty long time. So.
Yeah. And his, like, other GS9 associates went with him, right?
Yep.
Yeah. That's crazy.
They got caught for just putting it on Instagram. So, I mean, they just tell you when you
get it. They're trying to get publicity. If you want to get away with something, do not post it online.
Right.
That's so stupid. Like, some
That's
girl,
how people get caught. Bragging.
They're like,
like, yeah, I just sold this little glove. Like,
no. Right, let me put it on Instagram so everybody can see this.
No, it's up. Like they have this big old bag of money and they're like, just robbed the bank. Like, about to chill in Miami. Come get me.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Come on now.
But anyways, I don't know if you guys seen the Grammys on Sunday, but Kanye interrupted Beck because he thought Beyonce should have won.
Yeah. What is it?
Album of the Year?
Yeah.
And he made a big scene about it, and I guess people were playing salty about it.
Yeah. First, everybody thought it was a joke.
Then he was serious.
Yeah. I thought it was a joke. Honestly, I think that the next Grammys, they need to
not him in the back.
Beyonce or Beck?
Beyonce.
What I'm saying.
He has a point, but at the same time, that's so disrespectful. Like, if let him have his moment. He just beat Beyonce. He let him have his moment.
But then again, I see, like, he just trying to, like, sip up for her. Like, he should have felt. He felt like she should have won. Like, he did it in 2009. He did that for, He did it for Beyonce. And he interrupted Taylor Swift, I think.
Yeah.
So he had a good point.
But they knew Artist of the Year.
Okay.
Was Sam Smith.
Yeah, his voice is like butter.
It's like butter.
Yes,
it's so smooth.
Delicious. About concerts. I don't know about Lil Durk, but I mean, Death Bay, he had a little tour right now. He came to St. Louis. I don't know if y'all went, but I mean, I wanted to go, but I didn't go. But anyway, yeah, you should go look on his website. It's Lil Durk, HQ. Yeah, HQ.com, and it shows like, where else he's going next, and how much you gotta pay, and so on. So.
Or that you can go to Disney on Ice.
I'm gonna go.
It's Disney. Like,
Disney.
You're never too old for Disney.
Right.
Too old for Disney.
Who's going?
I am.
I'll take my sister.
You guys gonna go together.
Let's go.
One Direction is coming to the Arrowhead Stadium.
No.
July 20th.
Yes.
Oh my God.
That is so tight that they're doing it at the Arrowhead Stadium.
No, they keep changing the day. It's too hot in Missouri, number one, to be having it outside.
No, that is tight.
I feel like this year there's going to be a lot of good songs coming out because I feel like new people are like, it's like, you know how usually it'd be like the same people joining together. Mm-hmm. It's different people getting together now, so it's going to be like, it's going to be different. So like Lil Durk and Chris Brown, you wouldn't imagine them coming together and creating a song. So they're doing that, and Frank Montana's going to be in their song too.
Let's get more PG and talk about the Grammys when the Frozen soundtrack didn't win a record of the year or song of the year. And I was happy about it because
you were happy.
I am tired of hearing that song.
I'm sorry,
somebody said
that. I could have got something like
no.
It was a pop.
It's all right. I feel like all little kids love it though, cause like
I love it.
Kids watching my niece watching
it. It could be like the Disney Awards or something, but not the Grammys.
They don't got a Disney Award.
The Teen Choice Awards.
Well, when Teen Choice was coming, better get something because that was popular. It was huge. It was big, and it was amazing.
Picture, I think it was Monday night or whatever. It was talking about how like it ain't the same without Selena. So it's like and like at the Grammys, like they said she was there, she would have won like some of his stuff.
I bet. I mean, she just brought like a whole bunch of like she brought a lot of things. Like we probably wouldn't have a Jennifer Lopez.
Like till this, day, she's still like loved.
While we're talking about people who have gone on, today is the second year for Whitney Houston's death. Take a moment of silence.
For more on Patriot Talk, go to @THSNewsMedia on Twitter or go to THS News Media on YouTube.
And follow us on Twitter @THSPatriotTalk and #LRKV if there's a topic you want us to talk about.
Patriot Vision will return after these messages. And now, back to Patriot Vision.
Courtrooming in
was held on February 21st, reporter Ali Smart gives us the inside look on how successful the dance was. It was.
Truman's High School annual courtwarming was held on February 26th with the theme of Bruno Mars's Just the Way You Are. Along with the candidates, clubs and other activities took part in making a wagon. During the courtwarming assembly, many activities were held. Max Titus was a part of them.
It was fun representing the class in the assembly three-point competition.
At the game, Audrey Lovoto was crowned queen of courtwarming.
First, it was disbelief. I wasn't really sure if I had, I don't even know what I thought, but after that, it finally sunk in, and my dad gave me a hug, so that was a really cool, exciting thing that I didn't expect.
Student council member Maya Hartz explains how much of a success the dance was.
I think the music choice was pretty nice. They play a lot of songs from 93.3, so a lot of people knew them, so it was pretty awesome.
At the dance, Brendan Chandler was crowned courtwarming king.
It felt fantastic to be king. They called my name, and I was like, I don't know what to do. But I hugged my mom. She cried a little. I cried a little. It was awesome. But I stood there. I was like, oh my gosh, what do I do? And she came up and gave me the crown. Best feeling ever. Probably never going to happen again.
And this concludes your Truman's 2015 courtwarming. I'm Allie Smart, signing off for THS Patriot Vision.
The Star Steppers performed in their regional competition. Savannah Vineyard has more on the story.
The Star Steppers performed in the regional dance competition at Lee Summit North, competing against various schools around the area. The Star Steppers worked hard every practice to prepare.
Well, we did a lot of practicing and extra practices. Let's kick that. I did lots of strength and conditioning. We did lots of dances, wearing weights on our wrists and ankles.
Competition is a chance for the team to bond.
The favorite part about competition is just being with the team. It's a really amazing feeling to be on the floor with your whole team, to feel everybody's energy when you're out there, and just spend the day with your team is a really fun experience.
The Star Steppers placed third in POM and fourth in hip-hop, leaving a good start for the rest of their season.
So far, the season's been really good. We've made a lot of great performances at basketball games and football games earlier in the season, and now competition. We did pretty strong, and now we're getting geared up for state and nationals coming up soon.
The Star Steppers will perform at their state competition on February 28th, along with nationals in March. I'm Savannah Vineyard reporting for THS Patriot Vision.
Former Secretary of State Madeline Albright visited Truman students. Here's Jasmine with the inside look.
On December 4th, three students from Truman High School went to Truman Library to interview past Secretary of State Madeline Albright. Albright was the first woman to be Secretary of State and has spent a majority of her life standing up for women and human rights, political equality, and many other topics. It was an educational opportunity for all the students attending. Senior Zach Relihan states how this opportunity came about.
My government teacher, Mr. Byrne, came and talked to me about the opportunity of going because he felt that I had a good understanding of government, having taken his class, and that my public speaking skills were good enough to be able to sit on stage and ask her questions.
Seniors Relihan and Emery Staten tell about how they felt about getting to interview Albright, given that she is such a woman of importance.
So I was definitely nervous to meet her because she's so important. I wanted to make a good impression and make sure that she liked me. It was quite an honor to be in the same presence as her and to meet her and to be able to ask her questions, because she has such amazing experiences and such amazing knowledge that it was quite an honor to be able to get some insight into that.
It was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to be able to meet someone of her caliber.
Relihan tells about the pants Albright has been known for wearing throughout her life, some representing how she feels during times of political distress and some representing how she feels in general on a day-to-day basis.
I asked her about her pins that she's known for wearing. I asked her if any of them have ever gotten her in trouble, because she does wear them all the time. And then she told a story about how she wore the see no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil, like monkey pins, when she was in Russia. And then the Russian president took it as like she was like insulting them,
Well, she did. She said, I think your policies are evil.
The pins that are in the show are the pins that I wore while I was in office. So they all have some kind of foreign policy stories. And the whole purpose of the pin exhibit is you. Because I wanted to do something that was fun and educational and made foreign policy less foreign, and was able to tell stories that were part of, that explained what foreign policy was about.
Then, like, whenever something's going on, if something bad is going on, she'll wear, like, a snake. If something, like, happy is going on, she'll wear a butterfly. So, like, depending on the day. So I think it's just something that's been fun, and she's known for it now, so she just kind of sticks with it because she likes it.
The students tell about advice that Albright gave during the interview.
I think she's a great role model for anyone. She talked a lot about, like, women being, like, trying to, like, get ahead and be equal, but she had a lot of advice that kind of applied to both men and women. Just work hard and strive for your goals, and don't be afraid to say what you want to say, because if you don't say it, then it's not going to get said.
She said, there's no room for mediocre women, but there's room for mediocre men. So especially as women, you have to push yourself harder and just, like, to voice your opinion no matter what it is. That goes to everybody, because the world will miss out on your point of view if you keep it to yourself.
The event ended with handshakes between the students and Albright. It was a learning opportunity for everyone involved.
I don't want to go into politics, but I do want to go into law, probably be an attorney. So with that, I'm going to have to take what she said about being a woman and work my hardest to make sure that I'm not mediocre, so, because there wouldn't be room for me then. So
I'm Jasmine Machetti, signing out for THS Patriot.
Mr. and Mrs. Spirit was announced February 26th. Taylor Hickman has an exclusive interview with the winners.
Mr. and Mrs. Spirit was announced on March 26th, right before the boys' game. Class competition between seniors to see who is the most spirited.
Mr. Zedrickins and Ms. Jordan Sires!
The winners of Mr. and Mrs. Spirit, Jordan Sires and Cedric Gibbs, expressed the excitement of winning.
It was really cool because I was being recognized for showing the school spirit, and being able to put my name out there was pretty cool.
It was a really humbling experience. I mean, all those guys up there, we were all really spirited, and I didn't know who was going to win, so I was really surprised when they said my name. It's an honor to think that the school and my peers think that I'm spirited and I support sports and do all the spirit days and stuff like that, but overall it was really a humbling experience.
Congratulations to the winners. I'm Taylor Hickman, signing off for THS Patriot Vision.
I was recently given the opportunity to make a music video for the PTA's Founders Day, and here's what was produced, featuring Val Mathenia and the THS Media.
Them reading all their books, but that's not really her style. And they're all on the same chapter, but she is falling behind. Nothing in the world could take them from their books. Yeah, they're invincible, and she's just in the background. And she says, I wish that I could read with the cool kids, cause all the cool kids, they seem to fit in. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, with the cool kids. Talking with a big smile, talking about books they've been through. Yeah, they're living the good life, but he can't find which book to choose. They're reading faster, but he doesn't know what he's doing. He's not reading living life without knowing. And he says, I wish that I could read with the cool kids, 'cause all the cool kids, they seem to fit in. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, with the cool kids. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, 'cause all the cool kids, they seem to get it. I wish that I could be with the cool kids, with the cool kids. And they said, I wish that I could read with the cool kids, 'cause all the cool kids, they seem to fit in. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, with the cool kids. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, 'cause all the cool kids, they seem to fit in. I wish that I could be with the cool kids, with the cool kids. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, 'cause all the cool kids, they seem to fit in. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, with the cool kids. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, 'cause all the cool kids, they seem to get it. I wish that I could read with the cool kids, with the cool kids.
That's all we have for you this month. Have a great day, Patriots.